Talk to us a little bit more about it.
Are we talking about transoral thyroid?
Transoral, yeah. We're talking all transoral.
So this is an incredibly interesting story. So women in Asia, Thailand, Japan, South Korea, they abhor neck incision because it's viewed in Asian women as a real negative factor on their beauty. It's a cosmetic issue. And because of that, surgeons in Asia and other places have worked on remote access to the thyroid gland through the axilla or the armpit, believe it or not, through the breast or behind the ear. And all of these have been tried. Some have been tried in the United States. Mm-hmm. Many have been abandoned because they're just not good procedures for the majority of patients. The complication profile is just not acceptable. But then the idea came up, what if we went through the mouth? Began in Germany, migrated to China, and eventually found its way to Bangkok, Thailand, where I met a surgeon who was doing it, and he was extraordinarily talented. He's become a friend of mine. So I met him at an international meeting. We chatted. I saw his videos, and I said, you know, this is interesting, but I got to see it myself.
Right.
So I went to Thailand for a week. I examined the patients preoperatively. I went to the OR, and then I examined them again postoperatively. And it's the real deal. I became convinced it was a good, safe operation. Mm-hmm. Then I brought the surgeon back with me to the United States to help train us. And I was the first person to start a program in transoral thyroidectomy in the United States.
That is incredible. We have an image of a patient that you performed this procedure. The transoral through the mouth, and we want to see some of that before 4 days post-op and then 30 days post-op. So talk to us a little bit about this patient and what you did to correct those nodules.
Well, this patient had nodules in her thyroid gland. Mm-hmm. She's actually a nurse, well, I believe 3 children, just delightful. And I said, how do you tell a patient, you know, well, I've actually done 6,000 thyroidectomies through a neck approach, and I haven't done any yet through the mouth, but I'm ready.
And I can do this.
I can do this. And I have my colleague with me from Thailand, and she was one of my very early patients, mm-hmm. said, okay, I'm good for that. And we did it in her, and it went great. So we practice, we work to the laboratory, we work in simulation models, and then we do the real thing in the first patient. And I give those patients credit for being the first patient. But she did great, and she was so happy with the procedure. So when I came down to Florida about a year ago, I said, you know, I want to do this operation here at the Miami Cancer Institute. I talked to Mike Zinner. He said, Rob, we think it's great. We want to go for it. And I do believe that having options, mm-hmm. especially for some women, not for all patients, but for some patients, it's a big deal if they can avoid a visible neck incision.